Hello students, today we will learn about the one sample t-test and where we use one sample t-test and the assumption of one sample t-test. One sample t-test, where we use one sample t-test, test whether or not the population mean represented by our sample has some specified mean values. For example, medical students have higher GPAs than 3.5 mean value. Medical students done voluntary work more than 5 hours in a week. Okay, consider an example for one sample t-test. A researcher wanted to determine whether a program for routine cholesterol screening of college men would identify high serum cholesterol level. The researcher decided that above 20 would be the high. He decided to select 20 students were randomly selected for cholesterol screening, and the results are given below. Is there any evidence that asymptotic college men have elevated serum cholesterol levels? Would a large scale screening program be warranted? Use alpha level 0.05. Here 20 mean students cholesterol level are given. The first value is 260 and 150, 160, 200, 220, and the last value is 220. Here we first assume or check the assumption of normality. The normality assumption, many of the statistical methods that we will apply require the assumption that a variable or variables are normally distributed. The hypothesis code is data follows the normal distribution. Okay, first we open the SPSS variable view and then we enter the first variable name serial number and the second variable is cholesterol level and give the properties as first. Second property type is both variable are numeric with 8 and decimal places 2, and the full description of the variable is serial number of the patient and the cholesterol level, and the major of first variable is nominal and the second variable is scale, and the role the first variable is none and the second variable is target. Then in data view, we enter the data. First, we enter the serial number 1 to 20 and then we enter the cholesterol level. When we enter the data and to check the normality, we go to SPSS steps, analyze, descriptive statistics, and explore. When we press the button explore, the explore window pop up. In explore window, we move our cluster level independent list and press statistics or plots. Plots, we check the normality plots with test. Normality plot with test and press button continue and press button OK. When we press the button OK, in output window, results showed. The first table case presenting summary show the valid number, missing number and total number of observation or number of sample. And the descriptive table show the mean, 95% confidence interval and trim mean 95%, median, variance, standard deviation, minimum, maximum, range and difference of skewness, interquartile range and skewness and pertussis. The test of normality, the third table show the test of normality. Here SPSS showed the two normality tests, Kolmogorov Simrov test and Shapiro-Wilk test. The first one is the statistics and the second one is the degree of freedom and the third one is the significance, means p-value. Here p-value is greater than 0.05, so we reject our null, so we fail to reject our null hypothesis and consider the value of variables follows the normal distribution. When the assumption of normality is fulfilled, then we apply the SPSS, then we apply the one sample t-test in SPSS. One sample t-test, we have already entered the data SPSS option for the one sample t-test. First go to analyze and then go to compare means and then go to one sample t-test. And when we press the one sample t-test, the one sample t-test window pop up. The first window, one sample t-test window, show the right, the left side two variables, serial number and cluster labels. And we move the our test variable. Our test variable is the cluster label. We move with the arrow button in second figure. We move our test variable cluster labels and then type in test value. Our test value is 200. We decide in our example the our test value is 200. So we type in test value 200 and then press button OK. The output window show the results. If we enlarge this picture, here one sample statistics, the cluster level, a number of sample size, the n present with n, mean of cluster level, standard deviation of cluster level 32.16, which is 32.16, and standard error of means. Okay, the one sample test hypothesis testing window and cluster level t value is 1.877, degree of freedom is 19 and significance or p value is 0.076, which means is not equal to cholesterol level is not equal to 200, is greater than 0.05, is not equal to 200, and mean difference is 13.5, and lower confidence interval and upper confidence interval showed. Thank you so much.
Please subscribe and like our channel and press bell icon for more videos.